Hello everyone, myself Dr. H.S. Ullathyal, final year postgraduate, Department of Radiodiagnosis. I am from Sri Devarajaras Medical College, Tamaka, Kolar. My title is Determination of Gender Based on Frontal Sinus Dimensions Using Multi-Detector Computed Tomography. Myself Dr. H.S. Ullas, presenting author, and my co-authors are Dr. Revan Tarbi, Dr. Suraj H.S., Dr. Nikhilendra Reddy. Introduction. Gender determination of unknown people plays a prominent role in forensic investigations. Skeletal remains are being used in gender determination. However, when extreme postmortem changes have developed, as in explosions and various other mass disasters, identification and gender determination are difficult. Radiological identification of humans has major role in forensic medicine. In gender assessment, the skull is often used. The sinuses therein, frontal bone, can also be recovered intact from the fragmented remains and can be useful in gender determination. Frontal sinuses have a lot of variability because of its irregular shape, which make the frontal bone unique for every individual. Also, the frontal sinuses have a strong walls and the structure of it will not change after crossing the age of 20 years, except for rare occurrences as fractures, tumor or infection. The purpose of my study is to determine the gender based on frontal sinus dimensions using multi-detector computed tomography. The design of the study is the hospital-based retrospective study. Total number of studies, the minimum total number of study subjects is 116. In my study, 215 was included. The inclusion criteria is all patients who underwent non-contrast computed tomography brain and paranasal sinuses. Exclusion criteria is postoperative status and any road traffic accident involving frontal bone or sinus. Postoperative status for including for tumors or any other lesions. So analysis and statistical method. So the minimum sample size was 116 as calculated by Hamed et al. Study. And in my study, total 215 frontal sinuses were analyzed. So these are the images. Reference images. This is a coronal CT scan, shows the transverse dimension of the right frontal sinus. This is how I took the transverse dimension. And this is the axial CT scan, shows the anterior posterior diameter of right frontal sinus. This is the anterior posterior diameter. And this is the craniocaudal dimension of the right frontal sinus. Similarly, these dimensions were also calculated for left frontal sinus. So results. In our study, 215 frontal sinuses were studied with the age range from 20 to 70 years with median age of 44 were selected for this study. Frontal sinus dimensions for bilateral right and left sinuses, that is transverse, craniocaudal dimension and AP dimension, were measured from axial and coronal sections using multi-detector computed tomography scanner. Transverse and craniocaudal of left frontal sinus were found to be statistically significant. Lower values for the maximum transverse and craniocaudal dimension of the left frontal sinus in the female group were detected in comparison to male group. So the mean age of study population for right frontal sinus 44.1 and for left frontal sinuses it was 43.9. So total number of study subjects in males in right frontal sinus were 59. And in left frontal sinus were 59, and in female right frontal sinus were 47, and left frontal sinus were 50. Three less because the right frontal sinus were not at undergone pneumatization. And statistical differences in frontal sinus measurement in gender group. Here we can clearly see that the p value is less than 0.05. For transverse and craniocaudal dimension of the left frontal sinus. So there was a statistically significant difference between the male and female group in transverse and craniocaudal dimension of left frontal sinus. Next, we did the ROC curves for better assessment of frontal sinus measurement in the gender groups. Here also we can see that transverse and craniocaudal dimension of the left frontal sinus we plotted and we found it was statistically significant, and we made a discriminant analysis. Here both left frontal sinus and right frontal sinus, if we took the 69.8% were correctly classified, and only right frontal sinus it decreased. That is 57.5% were correctly classified, and in left frontal sinus alone, if we took 69.7% were correctly classified. So discussion, this study is being conducted to determine the accuracy and reliability of the frontal sinus dimension measurement by using MDCT scanner as a method for gender identification. Frontal sinus dimensions for bilateral right and left sinuses, that is transverse, craniocaudal dimension and anteroposterior lens, were measured from axial and coronal deformated sections. 4 mm slice thickness was used using MDCT scan. So the subjects included in the study were above 20 years old, and to exclude the possibility of incomplete growth. Statistically, high significant lower values of frontal sinus transverse and craniocaudal lens on left side were detected in females in comparison to males. The present results were consistent with Lee et al., who used CT imaging for comparing the gender and concluded that males had greater dimension in most frontal sinus measurements. So coming to conclusion, from the current work, we concluded that CT scan helps in accurate measurements of frontal sinus, that is especially left frontal sinus transverse and craniocaudal dimension, which is valuable in differentiating the gender. So these are my cross. Thank you, everyone.